Welcome to the presentation of the approach submitted by WEBIS at Track 2022 to the Deep Learning Track. This is Mike Fröbe, and I will present work that is done together with Lukas Gienab, Martin Potthast, and Matthias Hagen. Overall, we submitted 4 runs to the Deep Learning Track, and we focused on the passage ranking task and more specifically on the re-ranking subtask. So we re-ranked the official top 100 baseline. Here we see defined as a PyTerio baseline the starting point for our 4 runs. So we used the official top 100 baseline, re-ranked the top 100 with Mono T5, and the top 50 of the Mono T5 results were re-ranked with Duo T5. So it is a classical Mono Duo pipeline. We now have submitted 4 runs which are quite similar and focus specifically on the Duo T5 part. So we have a different version of Duo T5, and we also test this different version of Duo T5 with some augmentation of or with some data augmentation techniques that manipulate the input that is sent to the Duo T5 re-ranker. So the talk will focus quite a lot on Duo T5, so let me explain you the basics. So Duo T5 has as input a query Q, a document DA, and a document DB. So it has a triple consisting of query, document, and document as input, and it outputs the pairwise preference of those 2 documents. So the probability that document DA, so the first document, is more relevant to the query than document DB. That's the output of Duo T5. Let me explain this a bit in more detail with an example from the Track Deep Learning Track from 2019. The query is, what are the social determinants of health? And we have a document D1 which talks about social effectors which affect health are housing, income, education, and so on and so on. So this document is highly relevant and has a relevance score of 2. Then we have a document D2, which explains that higher levels of education are associated with better health. So it is still relevant, but not as relevant as document D1. So it has a relevance score of 1. And then we have a document 3, which is not relevant because it talks about social structure. Duo T5 now predicts all the pairwise preferences. So it basically builds a matrix of pairwise preferences and document, for example, and this matrix contains something like document D1 is more relevant to the query than document D2 with a probability of 90%, and D1 is more relevant to as document D3 with a relevancy of also 90%. So in those both cases, Duo T5 is perfect. And now it also makes the reverse predictions. So document D2 is only or is more relevant with 10% to the query, but it also can make inconsistent or contradictory predictions. So here, for example, it says that document D3 is more relevant than document D1 with 90%. So this contradicts each other. And what we now do, or what now the default approach for Duo T5 is to aggregate those scores with the symmetric sum. And the symmetric sum just sums the rows and columns here. And it now also has some inconsistencies here, and we just sum this up and get a score for document 1 of 2.8. And we also do this for all remaining documents and all remaining document pair preferences. And the interesting point is now that in this example, because the preference between the free and the one is noisy, this basically causes that document D2 gets a lower score than document D3. So D3 gets 1.7, D2 1.5. So this SimSum aggregation would rank D3 higher than D2. But when we look at the preferences between D3 and D2 in isolation, then Duo T5 would produce a different order, because it says D3 is only more relevant than D2 with 30%, but D2 is more relevant than D3 with 70%. So when we only look at the two documents, then then Duo T5 would rank D2 higher than D3, but this symmetric sum aggregation ranks D3 higher than D2. And now we want, of course, to find a solution for this, and a possible solution for this is a greedy aggregation scheme for Duo T5. So, and for this greedy thing, we use an greedy algorithm by Cohen from 1999. So a quite old algorithm, and I don't want to highlight all the things, but the main idea is that in each round you identify the document with the highest score and rank this at the next position, and then you remove this document completely. So you remove it from the rest of the ranking, from the remaining pairwise preferences. And let me explain this with an example. So the first step is we identify with this greedy approach the document on position 1. This is identical to the symmetric sum. So what this does here is that so we again compute all the pairwise preferences and identify that document D1 should be on position 1 because it has the highest score of 2.8. But then this greedy thing comes to play, and we virtually remove the document on position 1 from the computation. So of course the greedy algorithm makes this more efficient, but we can now imagine this as we remove the rows for document 1 and the columns for document 1 and the rows for document 1. So we only have this left. And with this we again do this symmetric something, and now we get the preferred ranking that document D2 is ranked before D3, because now only local preferences are considered, and we do not consider preferences to documents that are already ranked somewhere in the listing. And here we see the evaluation results. So this greedy approach is very simple, but it improves the effectiveness of Duo T5 quite a bit. So the NTCG at 10 improves from 048 to 052. The mean reciprocal rank also improves from 071 to 082. So both evaluation measures improve quite substantially when we apply this greedy aggregation scheme. And this is interesting to make a conceptual comparison here between SimSum and the greedy approach. So the motivation why we did this is because Duo T5 might, or we thought that they might produce contradictory predictions, and now SimSum uses all the information, but the greedy sum discards some information. And the hypothesis why this works, which is currently work in progress, is that greedy reduces the contradictions and therefore improves the effectiveness. And it reduces the contradictions by removing documents that are already in the ranking on some higher positions from the resulting score calculations. This is the first run the first two runs that we submitted, and we submitted two more runs, and there we applied augmentation and perturbation strategies for Duo T5. So the basic idea was to improve the effectiveness by decreasing the efficiency, and therefore we calculated multiple pairwise preferences for each document pair. And the input to Duo T5 is always a triple: query document, document. And we can now augment, for example, queries with user query variants, similar to what was done on Robust04. We have not submitted something here like this, but we applied some document augmentation. So, for example, use the first n sentences or expand the document with doc.t5 or replace the content of the document with predicted queries, also with doc.t5. So we use those document augmentations to produce multiple scores per document, and then we can or we have to aggregate them, and there we tested some min, max, average, and median, and here we get basically a wide bunch of different approaches, and we used a grid search on deep learning 2019 and 20 to identify the best the best combination of those approaches. But what we saw, unfortunately, in the evaluation now was that our augmentation strategies decreased the effectiveness, both in terms of NDCG at 10, but also mean reciprocal rank. So maybe the augmentation introduced more noise than value, and our current work-in-progress hypothesis is that manual augmentation, for example, with manual user query variants, would improve the effectiveness, and this is something that we want to study next. So to sum everything up, a simple switching in Duo-T5 from the symmetric sum to the greedy approach improved the effectiveness, but unfortunately our second evaluated approach, this augmentation, decreased the effectiveness. As future work, we would like to plug and play more summation schemes like the SymSum into the greedy approach and check if the greedy approach is always more effective. And when this is the case, we would like to ask why. We also would not give up our augmentation approach, so we would like to figure out how we can get this augmentation to work, and for this we would next start with some Oracle augmentations, for example with user query variants or simulated best case queries. That's it. I would like to thank you for your attention.